Jap Marais, November 2, 1922, Vryburg, August 8, 2000, Pretoria, was a Member of Parliament in South Africa, 1958-1969, and the leader of the Afrikaner Nationalist South African Political Party, the Herstig Nasionale Party, HNP, from 1977 to his death in 2000. His father was one of the first fighters to enlist in the Anglo-Boer War, 1899-1902, against British colonial forces in South Africa. Marais was active in Afrikaner nationalist politics from his 20s onwards. He was elected as a Member of Parliament for the ruling National Party in 1958 and served until 1969. The HNP was formed in 1969 by Albert Herzog, son of former Prime Minister General J.B.M. Herzog, and a cabinet minister, Marais, and two other MPs, Louis Stauffenberg and Willy Marais. Marais considered this measure as a concession under pressure that would result in other concessions until the whole political order in South Africa, at the time based on racial and cultural differentiation, separate group areas and white rule, had been dismantled. Jap Marais was thrown out of the Broederbond shortly after the HNP was formed, and all other identified HNP members or sympathizers were also purged from the Broederbond. Marais exercised influence as a thinker in right-wing Afrikaner nationalist circles from the 1970s to the 1990s. His thinking was influenced by Hans Strijdom and Hendrik Verwoerd, two Afrikaner nationalist leaders and prime ministers of South Africa. He wrote a political biography of Hendrik Verwoerd and many political articles and booklets. Langenhoven, Toby Muller, James Burnham, Alexis de Tocqueville, Edmund Burke, G.K. Chesterton, Alain de Benoist, Oswald Spengler, Arnold Toynbee, Ludwig von Mises, F.A. Marais considered identity, continuity, and freedom as the three key themes of Afrikaner nationalism. Such a group preference implied a related right among members of the group to differentiate and discriminate to exercise a group's preference. Among each people, according to Marais, there was a center of authority that determined who was included and excluded. In the case of Afrikaners, their centers of authority ensured that a racial preference for whites, the Afrikaans language, a distinctive Western culture, traditions, and history had formed the Afrikaner identity in Southern Africa. According to Marais, continuity depended on each generation maintaining what had been built up by previous generations and transferring it to the next generation. He emphasized Afrikaners' freedom struggle against foreign domination by British imperialism in the Anglo-Boer War, but also against American or Soviet Russian forces during the Cold War or the greater numbers of various black ethnic peoples in South Africa. In his view, this freedom was linked to the fatherland of Afrikaners, which he defined as South Africa minus the Asian and colored group areas and the various black ethnic homelands. The HNP found it difficult to make headway against the entrenched and relatively conservative ruling National Party in the 1970s. It succeeded in winning 18% of the vote in the white parliamentary elections of 1981. However, it did not gain any seats due to the electoral system, which was based on a Westminster system of electoral districts rather than a proportional system. Its electoral growth played a role in encouraging the breaking away from the National Party in 1982 of the Conservative Party under Andries Treurnicht. Under the leadership of Marais, the HNP challenged the policy of the National Party to negotiate with the African National Congress and South African Communist Party. He proposed a Volksfront, being a coalition of all the right-wing organizations with one objective, to stop President F.W. de Klerk from handing over the reins of government to the African National Congress. Instead, in 1992, a Volksfront was created from the ranks of the Conservative Party, and after 1993 led by Constant Viljoen. Today, the party still does not recognize the right of the African National Congress government to rule over Afrikaners in South Africa. The party also has not relinquished its claim to the previously white-dominated part of South Africa. It continues to encourage its supporters not to vote, as part of its policy of resistance. Jap Meroe claimed that it was the British and not the National Party of 1948 who had invented apartheid. Is it asking too much of English-speaking South Africans to acknowledge this evident truth? Meroe, who up to his death held to Verwoerdian apartheid ideology, wrote in the Sunday Independent. Meroe also demanded an apology from then UK Prime Minister Tony Blair for Britain's conduct during the Anglo-Boer War of 1899-1902, when it had instituted concentration camps in which 27,000 Boer civilians perished, 24,000 children and 3,000 women. Apart from being a politician, Meroe studied Afrikaans, Dutch, and English literature and translated William Shakespeare's Julius Caesar into Afrikaans.